associated with fine steaks, but we'll get to that in a minute. Now, the porterhouse itself is considered precious in large part because of location, location, location. That means the short loin. The short loin, composed of two main muscles. There is the large loin, or back muscle, and then there is the, or at least most of, the tenderloin. The other end of this is actually stuck into the sirloin. Now, this is a desirable location because it is far from both hoof and horn, and therefore does little in the way of work. Besides the T-shaped spine bone arrangement, there's very little connective tissue to complicate the meatscape, and yet, not all the steaks cut from this area are the same, okay? One must consider the fact that the tenderloin is a tapering muscle, small in the front, big in the back, and the loin, although consistent in size and shape, is completely clear of connective tissue at one end. And the other end, well, let's just say that it's starting to transition into a working class neighborhood. So, you know, it's like real estate. We really gotta go walk the territory. Come on. Despite the fact that these steaks were all cut from the exact same bolt of moo cloth, they change radically from here to here. And luckily, our government has sorted things out for us. The T-bone may be prepared from any short loin item. The maximum width of the tenderloin shall be at least 1/2 inch when measured parallel to the length of the backbone. Roughly, that means that everything here qualifies as a T-bone except maybe this guy and this guy. These will have to be sold as bone-in strip steaks. Nothing wrong with that. Now, this begs the question, when does a T-bone become a porterhouse? Again, from the government. And the porterhouse, the minimum width of the tenderloin shall be at least 1.25 inches when measured parallel to the length of the backbone. So, that helps. That means that this is a T-bone, and this is a T-bone. This is a porterhouse, 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 porterhouse. But even then, they are not all equal. For instance, when the tenderloin is the widest, the loin actually contains this kind of eye-shaped vein of connective tissue. And in this case, I mean vein as in, you know, like iron ore, not a tube that, you know, blood pumps through. Anyway, it's chewy stuff, so the quality here is definitely compromised. When we back up and see that right here in the middle, you get a smaller piece of tenderloin, but beautifully clear meat. If I'm gonna pay 20 bucks a pound for a piece of meat, this is the piece of meat I'm going to pay $20 a pound for. Let's go home.